everyone. First off, I have to apologize for doing this voiceover instead of having me talk at you live while the camera's going. For some reason, I have the mic volume on my camcorder set really, really high, so the volume and the sound was just awful. So I'm just doing it as a voiceover. But anyway, back to the card. This week's Make a Card Monday card, I'm using a lot of cut pieces for my Silhouette Studio software and cut it with my Silhouette cutting machine. So if you want to see how I created this design in the Silhouette Studio software, go ahead and click the link that's on your screen right now. It'll take you right to that video. So here's the first piece I cut, and I used Bermuda Bay cardstock from Stampin' Up, and this is the textured cardstock. I discovered that it was almost as great to cut with as the American Crafts textured cardstock. And I think because it's textured, it cuts just a little bit easier. So if you're looking for some Stampin' Up cardstock to put through your cutting machine, try the textured cardstock. It works just a little bit better. So this is a standard size card, so it's 4.25 by 5.5. It's just got that curved edge on the top. I'm just going to clean up this little notch right here that I created when I folded it. And the rest of the pieces I'm adding to the card are right here. I've just got some white cardstock and then also two pieces of pattern paper from American Crafts. It's from their Love Collection. It's the kind of like their Valentine's Day line that they've just come out with right before Christmas. And I cut these pieces with the silhouette because I wanted them to be the perfect inset shape with that curve on the top. So I'm just adhering that down to the card. And then I'm going to take the other two pieces of pattern paper, and they're actually going to go on the card with some dimensional adhesive. So I'm not going to adhere them straight to the card quite yet. I'm going to go ahead and adhere the smaller piece of pattern paper onto the larger piece of pattern paper first and assemble the card, and then I'll be putting it onto the rest of the card with some dimensional adhesive. These are some layered stickers from American Crafts, and I'm going to be using this rectangle piece here. And I designed the pattern paper cutting pieces to fit this particular piece with the sentiment on it, because I knew I was going to be putting it right there. So these are some paper flowers from American Crafts from that same pattern paper collection. And you can make some sort of accordion flowers like this on your own by hand, but this just takes it one step further so you don't have to worry about that. It's already pre-made for you. So I'm going to use this red one right here and just put it up here on the top portion of the card. Then I'm going to grab a couple more of those layered stickers and put one on there. And I'm going to put another heart-shaped one on, but I'm actually going to wait until after I have some ribbon on the card because it's going to overlap it. So the type of ribbon I used is some satin ribbon from American Crafts, or I'm sorry, from Stampin' Up. And you can just buy that out of the regular catalog. I'm just going to put that heart sticker right on top. And that pretty much finishes up the main portion of the card. I'm going to go ahead and adhere it to the front of the card using some Stampin' Dimensionals. Stampin' Dimensionals are my favorite foam dimensional adhesive. Use them all the time. You'll probably see them in every video. And I'm just going to place it on the center of the card. And one of the last things I'm going to do is just take a white gel pen around the outside edge of that white cardstock on the Bermuda Bay cardstock, just doing some dashed lines, kind of creating a faux stitching texture, faux stitching line there. And that finishes up the card for this week. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.